Hello learners, today we are going to discuss the meaning and significance of health under the subject code 508 and I am Dr. Gulshan Mufid, Assistant Professor, Institute of Vocational Studies. So, first we will discuss the learning objectives of this course. Number one, we are going to explain the importance of safe drinking water and safe food, state about proper lighting, ventilation and comfortable sitting arrangement, create positive emotional and social environment in the class, explain the importance of food and balanced diet, recognize communicable disease, describe good posture and healthy habits, understand and explain concept of health, describe the different aspects of health, understand the importance and significance of health for individual, family and society, understand and explain the relationship between health and education. Now, what is health? Health is a complex entity which tells us about efficiency of a living being. Health is not merely the condition of being free from illness, injury or pain. It is your overall state of wellness and all levels of your being: physical, social, emotional, mental and spiritual. Some of the factors that influence health are environmental, behavior, social, cultural, economic and political. The World Health Organization, WHO, also defined health as a state of complete or physical, mental and social well-being and not merely the absence of disease. The word health was derived from the old English word health, which meant a state of being sound. So, now come to the main aspects of health. Number one, physical health. Physical health can be defined as an essential part of overall health of an individual, which include everything from physical fitness to overall wellness. A good physical health means every external part of our body functions properly as it is commonly supposed to function. It also indicates the wellness of our internal body organs and systems. Number two, emotional health. Emotional health in this context includes one's ability to appropriately express their emotion, their ability to learn, and their ability to have meaningful social interactions and connections. Emotional health can lead to success in work, relationships, and health. Happy people are more likely to work towards goal, find the resources they need, and attract others with their energy and optimism. Now come the third aspect of health, that is mental health. Mental health is a state of well-being in which the individual realizes his or her own abilities. The individual can cope with the normal stresses of life, can work productively and fruitfully, and is able to make a contribution to his or her community. The importance of maintaining a good mental health is crucial to living a long and healthy life. Mental health can enhance the joy of living. Mental wellness is based on some of the following factors. These are critical thinking, problem solving, creativity, education and learning goals. Mental wellness is based on some of the following factors: ability to adapt to change, ability to access resources, mental status and abilities or challenges. A successful mental health program should help children in living to love learning, testing themselves, helping them learn to improve and develop their ability to concentrate. And this can also help in study skills, problem solving, knowing when to take a break. Now, the fourth aspect is social health. Social well-being is a very important part in creating and maintaining a balanced and healthy lifestyle. Students may become so overwhelmed with school that they might neglect this part of their well-being. Some components of social wellness include the caring and healthy relationship you have in your life, your social network, your level of safety, your housing situation, your level of interdependence, and if you are willing to accept and give help to other people, positive interactions with your community, that is volunteer work, your acceptance of diversity. This means accepting people regardless of their ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, ability or religion. A successful social health program should help children in learning how to communicate so they can be understood, how to deal with peer pressure in a realistic way, building confidence and trusting themselves, how to honor differences while respecting one's own point of view, compassion and empathy for others. The fifth aspect of health is spiritual health. Spirituality is unique to each individual. Your spirit usually refers to the deepest part of you, the part that lets you make meaning for your world. Your spirit provides you with the revealing sense of who you are, why you are here, and what your purpose for living is. Significance of health. Let's discuss why health is so significant. Health is an invaluable part of human beings' life. Without it, people can become uninspired, demotivated, and unable to thrive for success. So, some individuals visit their doctors regularly to make sure they are in tip-top shape. Likewise, there are those who purchase insurance coverage so they can receive the best healthcare should there be a need in the future. Then there are individuals who spend a lot of time and money to improve their health by going to wellness spas, beauty treatment, working out in gyms, and buying healthcare products, among many other things. What is the significance of health for individual? There are several advantages of a healthy life. Our body will be free from various forms of health problems, and thus we will get a longer life. We can live a life without suffering from aches, pains, and discomfort. Kids' health is important for proper growth and development of their mind and body. They require enough energy to spend the entire day in school. They should be able to focus in the classroom and fully participate in the activities on the field. For this, they need proper nutrition, which include carbohydrates, proteins, calcium, minerals, etc. Significance of health for family. The family as a social institution has its core relationship. Two parents tied together in an emotional axis from which stem many feelings, needs and actions, which are often poorly understood by the parents themselves. Each family evolves its own emotional atmosphere, and the emotional climate may have either a constructive or a destructive effect upon the child's health. Significance of health for society. When a person does not keep himself healthy, it can affect how he accomplishes his function for society. For instance, if he keeps getting sick, it will hamper his ability to do his work because he will keep on calling in sick. Significance for health in society. This would cause a chain reaction. The productivity of the company he works for will be negatively affected by his absences, and in turn, his reputation will be impacted. He may end up losing his job because of his sporadic attendance caused by being sick a lot of times. Education. Now, let's discuss the relationship of health and education. The relationship between health and education is a complicated one, with a range of potential mechanisms shaping the connection between education and health. Some explanations of this relationship are: poor health leads to lower levels of schooling, since poor health in childhood is linked to poor health in adulthood. Increased education directly improves health. Poor health and nutritional status of children is a barrier to attendance and educational attainment, and therefore plays a crucial role in enrollment, retention, and completion of school education. Increased education directly improves health. Effects of education on health. Education does not act on health in isolation from other factors. Income is another very important factor that interacts in many important ways with education as influences on health. However, empirical investigations often find that the effect of education on health is at least as great as the effect of income. It also helps promote and sustain healthy lifestyles and positive choices, supporting and nurturing human development, human relationships, family and community well-being. It is also important to emphasize that to the extent that education effects on health occur as a result of impacts on features of the self, particularly self-concepts and attitudes, then if the quality of education is not appropriate to the developmental needs of the individual, education can have directly injurious effects. Effects of health on education. The relationship between child health and schooling are very complex, and indeed there are multiple distinct relationships that are of potential interest, including the production function for academic skills, standard demand functions and conditional demand functions. It is very difficult, though not impossible, to credibly estimate the relationship between child health and education. Helpful school environment. School is an important and basic unit of the society. A good school with helpful environment is the foundation on which the society is based. In the school environment, child learns to eat, play, share and care, makes new friends. He becomes familiar with eating habits, food, cleanliness, hygiene and so many other things. School authorities and teachers should take care of all these aspects. Now let's discuss the clean drinking water supply. Main sources of drinking water are wells, river, ponds, hand pumps, taps, etc. Nowadays, water is polluted by washing clothes and utensils, throwing waste, drainage of chemicals and performing some rituals in the rivers. In urban cities, there are many methods to get clean water with the help of RO system and other purifying systems, etc. In schools, there should be provision of safe drinking water, covered storage of water, be adequate drinking water according to the school strength. In urban cities, municipal corporation plays a major role in supplying clean drinking water to schools. We should be particularly that in every school, the water storage tanks are cleaned regularly, special records are kept for the cleaning, water purify and chlorine tablets are provided by the school authorities. Teachers should give regular practice of not wasting water and reusing it for gardening, cleaning floors, etc. Clean toilets and urinals. Schools are the center to make children learn about the importance of hygiene. Necessary sanitation facilities should be made available in the schools. In this regard, school authorities and teachers have significant roles to play. So, what are the role of school authorities? There should be separate toilet blocks for girls in co-ed schools. Children must feel safe when visiting the facility without having risk for harassment, attack by animals like snakes in rural areas. Proper locking system, that should be, that means bolts and handles should be there in the doors. Supervisions by attendant in case of pre-primary and girl child. Sanitation facility should not contaminate groundwater. Toilet blocks should be cleaned twice a week or twice a day. Toilet and urinals should be physically challenge friendly, having low level handrails and ramps. Lighting and ventilation should be proper. Water supply should be adequate. Monitor regular use of toilet cleaners. Now let's discuss about what is safe food. Children bring food from home for lunch break. They are also getting midday meals. In some schools, there are cafeterias too. Safe food is very important for children to keep them healthy and away from diseases. There should be hand washing facility also. Children are taught to wash hands before and after meals. Teachers should also encourage them to wash hands even after handling animals, throwing garbage, visiting sick person, after playing, sneezing, coughing, using toilets and urinals. Some provisions to be made in the schools are proper and continuous supply of water, child-friendly wash basins at minimum height, proper arrangement of soap and hand wash liquid. Pre-primary students must be accompanied by teacher or nanny. Hand washing area should be cleaned regularly with cleansers. Wash basins should be according to school strength. In rural areas, water buckets, soaps and mugs must be kept. Drainage system should be proper. Proper drainage system is a need of every school to keep the environment healthy and clean. If drainage system is not well maintained, mosquitoes will breed freely in dirty and clogged water and there will be common diseases like malaria, dengue, etc. It will increase absenteeism also. The school authorities and teachers have a separate role to play to make the school environment healthy. Following steps should be taken by school authorities. Number 1. Covering of the drains so that there are no casualties. Regular cleaning of drains by local bodies to avoid blockage. Regular repair of the pipelines to avoid water clogging. Regular use of disinfectants, pesticides and insecticides to avoid the breeding of insects. Teachers to be attentive about the following things. No child should play near uncovered drain to avoid casualties. No child should throw any object like balls, stones, plastic bags and handkerchiefs into the drain to avoid blockage. No child should play with dirty clogged water. In rural areas where there are fewer facilities, teachers have to be more careful. We can overcome this with coordinated and combined effort of school authorities, local governing bodies, parents, teachers and students. So now we are going to discuss the refuse disposal. Fast development and flow from rural to urban have contributed to unhealthy environment in the metros like air and water pollution. The waste disposal is also one of the major problems. This can be easily controlled when we start taking initiative at the school level. We can manage waste by 4 R's, that is refuse, reuse, reduce and recycle. An activity can also be done in the class. The teacher can place 3 separate dustbins in the class A, B, C. Now A, the first dustbin is for the leftover food, B is only for papers, C is for plastics, polythenes and metals, and the teacher can ask the children to identify the waste and throw in the bin according to the material. Put waste of A in compost pit to prepare manure by adding garden soil, dried leaves and twigs. Put waste B of B in water. Add plaster of Paris, tissue papers and prepare different paper mache items like fruit, vegetable, pencil stands. For waste C, we can tell them that plastic material and poly bags are very harmful for our environment. After burning, they release harmful carbon dioxide. It should not be burned, rather sold out for recycling. What should be the lighting system in schools and classrooms? On a sunny day or cloudy day, the classroom should have proper light arrangements. Visual environment is very important for learners' ability and mental attitude. Proper lighting improves in respiration, heart action and brain activity, whereas dim light reverse effects as sleep being facilitated. Classroom should have warm color paints on walls to give more lighting effect. Teachers should be careful about lighting. Before starting the day, she should make sure that lights are on. Electrical wires should be checked regularly and replaces with new ones if damaged. What should be the ventilation system of the classrooms? Wherever we sit, stand or sleep, proper ventilation is required. Windows are the cheap and efficient solution to fresh air and climate control in schools. Children in well-ventilated classrooms perform better than their peers who get inadequate fresh air. Urban areas experience these problems more than rural. In rural areas, the classrooms are in open or in tents, whereas in urban areas, schools are in buildings, so ventilation is a hazard. Schools should have proper ventilation in classrooms with proper windows so that the classrooms are neither too hot in summers nor too cold in winters. There should be a comfortable seating arrangement also. To make the learning more effective, comfortable seating arrangement should be done in the class. Teacher can put her best to be comfortable and approachable to every child. In elementary classes, there should be different seating arrangements according to the activities to be done in the class, like group work, group discussion, writing work, performing art, etc. Teachers should be more careful about the seating arrangement of the child with special need. If a teacher is having children with special need or visual auditory problem child, he or she has to arrange their seats accordingly. So, let's discuss the seating arrangement. Seating arrangement includes group work seating arrangement should be in clumps or cluster. Group discussion teacher should have eye contact with every child. Writing work, every child should have clear view of the board. Performing art, children should be given enough space. Children with special need, they should be seated near the door. The troublemakers, they should be seated near teachers so that their activities are monitored well. Evaluation, teachers should have maximum space to monitor the children so that she can evaluate the students well. Teacher should make sure she or he has enough seats to accommodate the class. Conducive emotional and social environment. There should be a conducive environment in the classroom. Environment begins with the room and extends to the behavior of the teacher as well as the students. We don't mean only physical environment but emotional and social too. The teacher should establish an atmosphere that respects all differences in individuals. Students have opportunity to feel capable, connected and contributing members of the school. Students should be encouraged to become actively involved in their school and classroom activities. It becomes necessary for the teacher to take following steps to ensure that classroom is inviting and welcoming students. Number one, greeting program. Teachers greeting every student by name at the classroom door makes the child more comfortable. Newcomer club. Newcomers should be welcome and involved in school and classroom activities. Number three, changing seats. To create a classroom environment that enhances emotional and social relationship, changing seats frequently is very important. This allows a student to work with different classmates and make new friends. This also promotes social interaction and emotional bonding. One-on-one contact. Teacher should interact individually with every child to make him feel free, comfortable and more confident. Next, peer reading program. Senior should provide reading and other assistance to juniors. Now some health instructions. To inspire the child with a desire to be well and happy is possible only through health instructions about food, balanced diet, diseases, postures and healthy habits, etc. So learners, we have discussed few very important points regarding health and physical education. How we can take care of children's health by giving them a proper and conducive environment in the class. Hope that this lecture will be beneficial for you and we'll meet you next time. Thank you.